What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today, I'm going to show you how to render online using vray Cloud for Sketchup. Let's get started. So a couple of weeks ago, KS Group gave me access to vray Cloud, which is a cloud rendering service specifically for vray. So a huge thanks to them. vray Cloud is in beta right now, so you can request access by going to this link here. Once you have access to vray Cloud, go to your Sketchup model to start a render. First, go to the vray asset editor, then click on this arrow here and select this cloud icon to send your current scene to vray Cloud. Next, you should see a webpage open. Just use your KS Group account to sign in. After that, you will see this page, which is where you can submit a job or a render. There are also other tabs here, such as portal, which is where you can see current jobs that are in progress. You can have up to 10 active jobs at the same time, which is super awesome. Right now, I have no current job in the queue, so I can go back to the render tab. There are also a section for terms and for frequently asked questions as well. Here, you can change the job and project name. In this case, I will keep it as it is, but I will increase the resolution to 3840 by 2160, which is equivalent to a 4K image. Here, you can see the output format. If you want to change the output format, you have to do it within Sketchup before you start using vray Cloud. You can do that by using the Save Image option here and choose the file type like so. For now, I will keep the default output format settings as an EXR and click here to submit the render. It will take a while to upload your scene, depending on the complexity of your model. After it's done, you can click here to view the progress. There you go. Now you can let this run and continue working on your model, or add another job if you want. Or you can just sit back and relax. When the render is completed, you can look at the sidebar here to see some information, such as the render time and how many credits were used. Now I'm going to click here to download the images. It will be downloaded as a zip file, so just extract it. Here I have an EXR file, a JPEG file, and a vray correction controls file. With a quick look at the JPEG file, you can see that the render looks really good. But where are the render elements? To get render elements, you have to open up the EXR file. To do that, open up Sketchup. Next, open the vray frame buffer window by clicking this button here. Or you can also go to the asset editor and click here. Then click on this icon to load an image. Make sure that you select the right type of file here. In this case, we are looking for an EXR file. It might take a while to load depending on the size of your image, but there it is. Now, remember that correction control file earlier? That file is for the global settings of the vray correction controls. Here you can see that it's set to default and none of the settings are on. So I'm going to click here and load in that file. There we go. You can see that some of these settings are now turned on, which reflects my correction control settings of the original model. The more important side of this is that you get all of the render elements here. And you can save all of these images by holding down this button and choose this option to save all. There we go. That's how you can render online using vray Cloud for Sketchup. And that's all for today, guys. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video. Comment below if you have any suggestions. Stay inspired, guys, and I'll see you next time.